2023 Atlanta International Auto Show. I'm back at the World Congress Center, the Georgia World Congress Center. This is where the boat show was a few months ago. Got some more stuff here. Got a Malibu right over here. It's a 23. Wow, it's pretty neat that this is still being made in the 2023 model year. I thought this was discontinued a few years back, but I guess not. Here we're in the Chevrolet section. The fuck is this? Oh, fuck that. It's a fucking EV. Fuck this shit. Ah, here we go. Beautiful looking C8 right over here. Sweet. Wow, what a monster. These are selling like hotcakes. I have the C7 Stingray, the front engine, whereas this one is mid-engine. I know that I have demonstrated this a lot on my channel, but this is the 8th generation of the Corvette. And of course, it's very popular, that's for sure. That beautiful V8 in there, what a monster. It's locked so we can't climb inside it, I don't know why. But yeah, there's the interior shot in there. And here's the Z06 version with a flat plane Ferrari sounding V8, which is interesting. Although it's naturally aspirated, it's not turbocharged. This basically is a former shell of what Ferrari once was. Because Ferrari now is turbocharged and stuff. This is naturally aspirated. 670 naturally aspirated horsepower, screaming at over 8,600 RPM. Sounds just like a Ferrari, but it's in a Chevrolet. That's pretty interesting. I've seen some of this at a few car meets here and there, and it's very interesting. It's starting to become tested more and hopefully tuned up a bit to make even more power by other tuners and stuff like that. And there's the specs on it. Wow. What a monster. And here's the Blazer. Although it looks more like an Equinox to me. A real Blazer is rear wheel drive with a V8. Okay, this one's got a V6, but it's all wheel drive, so you get better traction at least. And another C8 Z06 right over here. Wow, this one's got different rims. Actually, wait, no. It's the E-Ray. So basically, it's a hybrid Corvette. So, it still has the beautiful LT2 6.2 liter V8 engine, but it has a little small electric motor powering the front wheels, making it all-wheel drive. So it's like a hybrid, basically. It's interesting. And it's definitely brand new. It just came out. And I heard this monster creates over 650 horsepower. Naturally aspirated with the electric motor on the front wheels. I mean, hey, that's pretty impressive. The V8 engine powers the rear wheels while the electric motor powers the front wheels. I may be wrong, but as I've heard, the E-Ray, this is all-wheel drive, and it's a hybrid. So it's an interesting take on the Corvette. Definitely a new generation supercar, that's for sure. And there's a Camaro right over there next to it. Although, it's kind of funny because the front bumper looks very similar to the Z06. I mean, I think it's the same bumper. I may be wrong, but I think it's the same bumper. But yeah, it kind of confuses you a little bit. And here's another Blazer right over here. Although, it's not a real Blazer, in my opinion. And here's a Dually right over here. With a good old tried and true Duramax diesel. 6.6 liter, torque monster. And look at this, you could actually climb inside it. And it's got a brand new interior as well. Got a screen in front of there. How does it feel in there?
Luxurious.
Yeah?
Spacious. And comfortable.
Okay. I wonder if you can haul heavy loads in this and probably go off-roading with it. I'm sure you can. Oh, yeah. Not gonna lie, this is a good-looking truck. It's got a different front end than before. Oh, check this out. It even has a hood scoop on the hood. That's kind of new. And I think I saw this here last time. This is the 6500 HD. The dump truck. I think I saw this here last year. With that beautiful torch red paint, just like my Corvette. With a rigid dump body. And here's the inside of the bed. You can haul all kinds of stuff in there. Also Duramax power. There's the hood latches that open the hood. A lot of heavier trucks have this kind of design. Good job keeping this thing clean, sir.
Trying.
Well, you're doing great.
Thank you.
Yeah. These looking beautiful. I'm loving them. And there's the 2024 3500 High Country Dually. It even has a little bit of a little step stool right there, so you can climb inside the bed right there. That's Bedliner, but I prefer my boss's Bedliner better. Danny's Bedliner looks better than this, obviously. But hey, here's the inside of it, and it looks like it has an iPad-style touchscreen in the center console. That's interesting. And here, I'm gonna climb inside now. Oh, wow. It's comfy and spacious in here. Little iPad-style computer screen. It's got a sunroof right up there, too. And a digital instrument cluster right in front of the steering wheel. That's pretty interesting. And here's the 2500 HD Z71. Also the Duramax. Love this one. And here's new police interceptor units that just came out. And here's a Mustang police car. Imagine running away from this in Need for Speed, huh? Wow, these are crazy. And check out this monster-sized bumper. It's a grill guard. Basically, a lot of heavy trucks have this kind of design, but on a police car, that's built to take a lot of abuse. This is from the Fulton County Sheriff's Office. And here's the Tahoe as well. It's got the LED light bar. And even covered windows right here to take protection from gunfire and bullets. So if these go into a firefight, then these will be extra secure. And here's an F-150 as well, police unit. These are pretty neat. But you don't want to get arrested in these. Ooh, these little golf carts, whatever these things are. Golf cars of Canton. Oh, that's cool they have golf carts here. Never expected that. Yeah, golf carts are fun. Even though they're electric, they're okay. They're not too bad. They even have some gas-powered ones, too. This one's got multiple seats on it. It's got three rear seats. They're all bench seats. And on the rear seat here, you can climb up on this step stool and you could sit right here inside it. You like that, huh? It's fun.
I want to transport to a bed.
You want to what? Oh, yeah? Ah. And look at this. They have little cup holders right here. That's pretty cool. Wow. I've never seen that before on a golf cart. That's pretty creative. Oh. Oh, yeah. Yep. Start them young. That's right. Here's another Chevrolet truck here. Silverado LT right over here. 4x4, they're getting inside it too. And another Z71 right over here, 2500 Duramax. And here's the, I think this has got to be the top of the line Silverado called the RST. You can get inside it as well. Also a Z71. Similar looking interior as the heavier duty version. Ooh, here's a more off-road spec. Let's see what this is. It's called the ZR2. 6.2 liter V8. Hell yeah, brother. Four-wheel drive, you need that for off-road traction. Neat looking interior. Wow, a lot of rear seat room. I wonder if you could take those out. Can you take these rear seats out to save weight?
I have no idea.
Because, hey, weight reduction, that'd be pretty cool.
I don't think so.
I think you can with a little bit of gutting and tuning, maybe. Maybe there's some tuners that can probably have a way around there, maybe. And that's the bedliner. Doesn't look as good as my boss's bedliner.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Ooh, what's this? Is this like a
comic book adventure? You get to get yourself into your own comic book.
Dude, that's awesome.
All right, would you like to do the Soft Mat Racers, the Great Forest Adventure, or the Rocky Mountain Rescue?
Wow.
Middle one?
Wow.
Middle one? Alright. Yeah, they also. Alright. So you're getting ready to go on an adventure.
Wow.
So this first picture, y'all excited. Y'all
I have a Corvette.
Yeah, we're ready to go.
Yeah, C7.
Right. So let me see
yep.
You're excited.
I love it.
Let me see
it. My favorite car in the world.
Hold that excitement pose. Let me see. Hold
oh,
that
yeah, it's
pose.
The best.
Hold it.
21,000 miles and going strong.
Perfect.
It's the best.
Right, so now you're on this adventure.
Yep, I love
your
it.
Hands in your cheeks, you're screaming.
What's your favorite car?
So let me see both of y'all faces in that screen, screaming. Let me get you in there more. Let me see you in there. Let
yeah.
Me see. Yeah. All right, screaming. We're screaming. We're horrible. Ah! Perfect.
Comic strip. So that's what this is. That's cool.
You're gasping.
Pretty impressive display you got here. I like that.
Yeah, I'm used to that one.
Yeah, that's pretty neat. And right over here is Lexus. What's this? LC500. I think this was here last time. It's a convertible. You can also get inside it. And it's a V8, which is awesome. Wow, look at the interior of that. It's pretty interesting. But it's got a hideous looking front grille. That's the only gripe about it that I have. And what's this one? Oh, RC350 F Sport. And it's a V6. although I prefer the RCF with a V8 better. But I can't stand that hideous front grille. That looks disgusting. Oh, that's got to be the LS, but yeah, that grille is hideous. I mean, Lexus used to look good, but now they have that grille on pretty much every one of their models. That's a turnoff for me, and to some others too. I mean, it looks pretty controversial. It's kind of weird. Let's see what this is. That's a GX460. Also with a V8. At least that. And you could get inside it as well. And this is the new RX that's on this turntable here. Doesn't look as hideous as the others. Let's see what this is. It's got a tiny four cylinder. Yeah, but how much does this thing weigh?
Well, it depends on what model that you're going to get, because you have an RX500H that gets 366 horsepower, or you can get a 350H, or you can just get your regular 350, so it's just really all going to depend on which vehicle that you get.
I know, but having a teeny tiny baby-sized engine in a monster vehicle like this, I mean, it's got to work hard. It's got to move all this big weight.
That's why you have the new direct-four transmission, so you have a motor up under each tire, so that's what's going to give you that power.
So it's a hybrid, basically, right?
No, it's a gas model and it's a hybrid, so you have either or.
Oh, okay, so it's the same thing?
No, it's either or.
Oh, okay.
Either gas or you can get a hybrid.
Okay.
But it's definitely a turbo, so it's better fuel economy, but it's stronger and you're getting a better towing capacity and it's faster.
Although 275 horsepower, that doesn't look that powerful to me.
That's 275 horsepower to 350. Your 500H gets 366 horsepower.
Okay, that's
better.
Like
I said, it just depends on what engine and trim level that you're going to get with your RX.
Ah, gotcha. Mm-hmm. Although, I like the LFA with the V10. That's basically the two-door, two-seat V10 sports car they made from years ago.
Production.
I mean, putting that V10 in this would make it so much fun.
Yeah.
I got a feeling it would.
It would, but we don't have that because that is a sports vehicle. And this one is
well, hey,
one.
Come on. I mean, some people might like that. That would make a great selling point, not going to lie. I think so. Yeah. See, and here's Nissan over here. Start your journey here. Thrill Machine. Ooh, the new Nissan Z's on the console cover there. Okay, let's see what this is. It's a crossover SUV of some kind. I don't know what it is, but oh, it's a Rogue, but it only makes 200 horsepower. That's not much you could do in that. 200 horsepower in a big honking SUV like this, there is not much you can do. Oh, there's a dude on a skateboard. Go Rogue. Yeah. And there's the Pathfinder. This looks redesigned. I like that grill. That grill looks pretty cool. It's called the Rock Creek Edition. It's got off-road tires on it. That's neat. Hope it's got a V8 still. It better. Sporty looking interior, not gonna lie. Ooh, and here's an off-road spec Frontier. This is called the Pro 4X. It's got a roll cage on it and a roof rack, just like in SnowRunner. Wow, that's pretty cool. And this is called the Kicks. Kicks? What a dumb name. A Kicks? Come on, you could have named it something else. What does Kicks even mean? Is it kick you in the face? Or what? I don't get that. Ooh, and here's the new Z. This is one of the things I came to see. This recently came out in Forza Horizon 5. It's got a turbo V6, making over 400 horsepower. Twin turbo, actually. I wonder what the Drift King would think of this.
Just if I can turn on the lights. You're good to
Wow. It won't be long before somebody LS swaps this bad boy. Or maybe puts in maybe a RB2060 ETT in here. Or SR20DET, God knows what. That, you know, this will probably get a lot of tuners going and stuff. It'll turn a lot of heads with tuners. I can see that happening. It's got a newer interior as well. This looks like something the Fast and Furious Drift King would drive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know, right?
I wonder when somebody's going to LS swap this thing or something. Or maybe put in an RB2060 ETT or SR20 in here, right? I mean, it's bound to happen one day. It's going to. I got a feeling. It will. Yeah. That is ridiculously complicated. How do you work on this? That looks too heavy. Looks like it'll break down.
We need a doll.
Ugh, this thing's disgusting. Araya? That's a woman's name on a car. Really? I mean, sure, the Lotus Elise. That Elise is a woman's name, I get that. But having this on a disgusting-looking crossover SUV? Yeah. And add insult to injury, it's got a battery underneath. And you can't hear this thing coming towards you. It's disgusting. It's propaganda. And here's Jeep over here. Got some new Wranglers. I like that red. Let's see what that is. It's the Sahara edition. Looks roomy on the inside. Oh, Sarm Young. That's right. Yep. Yeah, looks like she wants to be a future Jeep owner one day, huh? Yeah. Hey, buddy. Yeah, start them young. Wow. And right over here is a Mojave Edition. It's a Gladiator with Mojave Edition. It's pretty neat. Wow. That looks pretty neat. Sweet looking interior. I like that. I like your shirt. Believe Atlanta.
Yes, sir.
That's right, dude. And this one looks pretty ugly right over here. I don't know what this is. Oh, it's a Renegade. Let's see. Oh, yeah. It's made in Italy where they make Ferrari and Lamborghini. And the engine's made from Poland. Huh. You don't really see a lot of that in a Jeep. And here's the Challenger. 345. I wonder what that means. RT Plus. So it's got the 5.7 liter Hemi that we all know and love. What a monster. And some ugly looking crossover SUVs over here. I don't know what these are. What is it? The Cherokee. Yeah, it actually looks pretty ugly in this one. The older Cherokee looks so much better. The new one looks pretty damn ugly, not gonna lie. Oh, sorry. And let's see. This one is this the Durango? It's gotta be the Durango. It's got a Hemi in it. Thank God for that. It's a sweet looking interior. This one actually looks pretty good. This one's gotta be the Durango. And there's the Wagoneers. My mom and dad and I have one. Thanks for saving our country, sir. Yep. Yep, we have the Wagoneer, and we love it. And here are the Ram trucks over here. Bighorn, oh, what a monster. It's got a long bed, crew cab, Cummins diesel. What more could you want in a truck like this? Dude, what a monster. And that Cummins is tried and true and proven. Definitely. Here's a 1500 Ram right over here. The blue paint. That looks pretty neat. Let's see. It's got a Hemi in there. I don't know what e-torque means, but hey, at least that's got a Hemi. You gotta love the Hemi. Ooh, check these little cupboards right out here. These cubbies on the side of the bed are actually additional spaces so you can haul stuff in the bed sides. Now, that's pretty cool. I believe it's called Brand Box. I think that's what it's called. There's more Rams right over here. Oh, now this one looks really cool. It's called the Power Wagon. I have this in Forza. Let's see. Wow, what a monster. 2500 Power Wagon. That's got to have the 392 Hemi in this. Wow. What a monster. It's like the off-road spec of the heavy-duty Ram. Gotta love that. And that's the Pacifica minivan. It looks okay for a minivan, but nobody buys minivans these days. Because, hey, it looks like these have a cult following. And they actually look a lot better than cookie-cutter crossover SUVs that everyone's pooping out and buying these days. That's for sure. And here's Kia, although the logo looks a bit like KN. So it looks like it's saying K and N. If you look at it real close, it almost looks like it says KN. Now that's a bit misleading. Now here's the Sorento, looks okay. And this one's a hybrid. All-wheel drive, it's okay. Oh, sweet, they got a simulator over here. You can actually drive these cars in these simulators. That dude's on a racetrack. Wow. It's like he's on the Nürburgring. Wow, he's ripping, he's having a good time. Let's see. See what this is. Ew, Nero Pro or Nero Wave? What's that supposed to mean? That's hideous. And it's a fucking piece of shit EV. Fucking. Ooh, the Stinger! A legendary performance sedan. Unfortunately, it got discontinued just recently. Very sad.
Which one?
This one, the Stinger. Yeah, discontinued just recently.
Why?
Sad. I don't know why. I mean, it's either people didn't want them or, you know, the manufacturer didn't care anymore. I don't even know, but this was a pretty damn good car, not gonna lie. I mean, you can tune this V6 pretty good. I mean, you can make lots of power out of this.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you can. And that one looks pretty cool with those rims and stuff. And that one's on a turntable. This one's a hybrid. I don't know what this is. It looks pretty ugly. It's also a Sorento, but it looks ugly. K5. I don't know what this one is. K5 GT. Oh, it's front wheel drive. So you gotta haul all that weight. More stuff over there. Ooh, look over here. Got some performance cars over here. Check this out. Got a whole row of Dodge Vipers. Check this out. A family of Vipers from every generation, from the late 90s through 2016. Check this out. V10 powered performance monsters. You gotta love these Vipers. The main competitor to the Corvette. 8.4 liters or 500 cubic inches and between 450 to 600 horsepower, with its highest version making 645 horsepower. That's insane. And that's going through a manual transmission that you have to manually shift yourself. Wow. They're very desirable too. Here's Volkswagen over here. The GTI, very desirable. Everyone loves a good old GTI. And what is this ugly looking piece of shit? ID4? Hideous. I'm guessing that's fucking electric. It's disgusting. And let's see what this is. Tiguan? Tiguan? What does that mean? That's a weird sounding name. What kind of name is a Tiguan? That doesn't make any sense. What's this? Taos? What's Taos? What does that even mean? That sounds kind of weird. Yeah, these are kind of boring. Except the GTI Golf. That's the only good Volkswagen that's being made now. The rest are pretty boring. And here's Lincoln over here, which is Ford's subsidiary. Whoa, the new Aviator. That looks pretty luxurious on the inside there. And I'm not sure what this one is, although this one looks kind of ugly. Oh, here's a tiny boy. Let's see what this is. Corsair. I wonder what that means. I guess it's a hybrid? I don't know. Looks pretty ugly, not gonna lie. And Lincoln, I mean, I don't think they have much of an offering, but looks like they got the Aviator and that ugly looking thing, and that's about it. Here's Toyota over here with the Tundra TRD Pro. Although this one's a hybrid with a turbo V6, although the V8 version was so much better. I mean, the only thing you get in here is a turbo V6 hybrid. V8's better. It's more reliable than this. V8 version was so much better. Don't know why they made it a turbo V6. That's kind of dumb. Because it's got to work a lot harder to move this thing. It's very heavy and all that stuff, you know? And this one's got its bed open, its bed liner. And this one, whoa, look at this big boy. Let's see what this is. iForce Max. Let's see what this is. Limited. What is this? Is this a Sequoia? It could be. What is this? Is this a Sequoia?
It
or
is,
what?
Man.
Oh, it is a Sequoia.
It doesn't look like the old one.
No, no.
I'll be honest, I always liked them, but I thought they were really ugly, but
yeah.
Either way, it's a good truck.
Although, is it a V8 or a V6?
That's what I don't know. Because I know the Tundras, I think, went away from the V8.
I know, and I hate that. It sucks.
Yeah, but I don't
yeah.
know what kind of power they were supposed to.
Well, it should definitely make more power, though.
Yeah.
Here's the Tacoma, the baby version of the Tundra, which is still selling like hotcakes. Pretty decent truck. Here's the Corolla, which there are thousands and millions of these sold worldwide. One of the most reliable cars ever made. And there's the Camry. Ooh, I like this one with the bronze or gold rims. This one looks pretty cool looking. It's funny that not many people say that about Toyotas, but not gonna lie, this one looks pretty damn interesting. Pretty nifty looking, not gonna lie. And here's another Camry. It says best-selling car right here. Let's go to four cylinder. 206 horsepower. That's not a lot though. And here is the GT86 right over here, which is a very fun little sports car powered by a Subaru Boxer four cylinder engine. Because this car was co-developed by Toyota and Subaru. So they have a twin version called the Subaru BRZ. It's a very compact car, a cheap car, and it can have engine swaps such as an LS. or anything you could throw in it. And it even has rear seats, which is kind of odd for a sports car. Start them young. Yep. And another, '86 right over here. There's its Subaru engine, the boxer four-cylinder. I think it's called the D45. That's probably why. And it's turbocharged, I think. Let's see. 228 horsepower, so it's got a bit of a power bump from its first generation. And that's always a good thing. Oh, this one looks pretty cool. This one's a little bit more pricier. Actually, it's the Supra. So basically, it's a BMW Z4 with a BMW engine and a BMW transmission, all used in this one car. And that's it. That's all it is. And here's the new Prius, which is completely redesigned, and it actually looks pretty sporty. For the first time in forever, the highly famed Toyota Hybrid finally actually looks good for once. It actually looks like a performance car. Finally. And I don't know what this thing is, because this one looks pretty ugly. A lot of these are just boring looking crossover SUVs. Not that exciting to me. There's a new Sienna minivan, which has been redesigned as well. A lot of room in there too. But unfortunately, nobody buys minivans these days because of everyone's got a boring looking crossover like that. Ooh, what's this? This looks interesting. What's this? This one's custom. How about that? A custom 4Runner off-road package. I like the paint job on there and the decal stripe on the side. That looks pretty cool looking. And there's Subaru with the BRZ, which is the twin of the Toyota 86. And another WRX STI Impreza. I don't know if it's a WRX, but it's got to be an Impreza. This one looks pretty neat. Let's see. Oh, it is the WRX. Very desirable. And boring crossover SUV thingy. Don't know what that is. I think it's an Outback or something. I don't know, but it looks pretty ugly. Let's see. Oh, and look at this. There's more classic cars right over here. In this section here, some of them have information on them. They're from Hagerty. And there's a C8 Corvette in the background and the convertible version of one of my favorite classic dream cars, the 1970 Chevrolet Chevelle SS. Whoa, Superfine 59. So this is the Pontiac Bonneville. This looks pretty sweet. It's also a convertible, 1959. Ooh. Here's a 67 Pontiac Grand Prix convertible next to it. What a big boat that is. And here is the beautiful Z28 Camaro from 1969. You gotta love this monster. This could win just about any race you could throw at it. This is what started the rivalry between the Camaro and the Mustang of muscle cars. The Mustang's right over there, actually. Lamborghini? I'm not sure. I saw some Lamborghinis here before, but like I haven't seen one over here yet. But of course the C8 Corvette, that's a mid-engine supercar. You should check it out. It's right over there. Right over there. Yeah, check it out right over there at the Continental Tire booth. Yeah. Yeah. Start them young. It's all right. Yeah, he's excited. Yeah, start him young. He's a gearhead. I love that. You know?
I want to code a car game now.
All right, guys, let's go see these. Yeah, see this car.
I play Forza all the time, and as well as Need for Speed. Yeah, I have a Corvette as well, but not this one. I got the front engine Corvette. Well, yeah, definitely because of different weight distribution, since the engine's behind the driver, gets you better handling and stuff.
bad.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, huh? So this one has the wrap from Continental Tire. So Continental Tire is the sponsor for this Corvette C8 right here, which is pretty neat. And they have a booth right here demonstrating all their tires, and look at this. They have a crane game. Check this out. Continental Tire has a crane game that you can play and win prizes out of. Wow, and that chick is controlling it. That's really cool. Wow, this is really cool. I've never seen that before. Here's some of the tires on display, which is really cool. And right over here on this side, we got some beautiful cars over here. We got a C8 Corvette and a C7 Corvette, the ZR1 right over here, and the C8 Stingray right here, and a McLaren right over here. I'm guessing that's got to be the 570S or something. And a Maserati convertible right over here. And a cool looking wagon. That's got to be a Chevrolet Nomad or something. That looks pretty sweet. And over there are some booths and tables that you can eat at. You can actually eat here, which is cool. Whoa, look at this. What a monster. Yeah, wagons are fun. They got a lot of character. They do. Here's a Chevrolet step side. And next to it, one of my classic dream cars, the 1970 Chevrolet Chevelle SS. You gotta love this monster. Wow. The big block 454 in this beast. You could also get one with a 396 big block too. Or even an LS swap if you go aftermarket and God knows what. You do whatever you want with this monster. Make it a drag racer or a streetcar build. You do anything you want with this. It's a big boat and I love it. And check this truck out. Another Chevrolet, that's got to be an Apache 3100, I think. And here's a Toyota FJ Cruiser, which is basically the Toyota's version of a Jeep, if you will. And there's a C3 Corvette convertible right over here. Yeah, not many cars at this event, but a decent amount, if you will. And I'm sorry I had to keep this quick because my mom and dad have other things to do since I'm here with them, but you know, they wanted to enjoy this with me as well, but they got other plans, so I'm going to be leaving soon, unfortunately. But I feel like I got some good footage. Here's another truck right over here. Another Chevrolet 3100. This one's lifted. That one looks pretty neat. Oh, check this out. Here's a little model car on the flatbed of this Japanese mini truck. I don't know what this is. Is it a Daihatsu or what? I think it is, but you know, these K trucks, as they're called, they're tiny and they're not very fast, but Japan loves them. And some of them are coming over here to the States, at least. People like them. And I actually worked on one of these with my boss, with Danny. I helped him put the doors on a Honda Acti mini truck of this similar type. But the driver's seat was on the wrong side. This one's got the driver's seat on the correct side, at least, which is pretty cool and interesting. And here's a mini tiny car right over here. I don't know what this is. What's it? It's a Trabone. I think that's what it is. I don't know. Where did this come from? I have no idea where this car's from. Ooh, and look what's behind it. The beautiful and legendary Hummer H1 Alpha. Look at this monster. 6.5 Detroit in this beast. Basically a civilian customized military truck. And Arnold Schwarzenegger even has this beast as well. Check this out. And it's highly customizable and very desirable. Wow. That is a good looking Hummer. Based on the Humvee military truck, but this is the civilian version. And here's another Viper right in front of it with a V10. You gotta love that. And I haven't checked over there yet. Let's see what's over there. Got some more cars over here. but I don't think there were as many here as last time. And of course, there were definitely more boats in this location than cars. Good job keeping it clean. I have a
C7. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's my favorite.
Okay, that's what's up.
Yeah, although it's got Michelin tires on it, not Continental. Sorry about that.
Oh, but you know, this is a C8.
Yep, C8s are good, yeah. This is a good one, yeah. I love it. Definitely. And props to you guys for making this wrap on it and putting in that cool, fun crane game in there. That's really fun.
Yeah.
I like that.
You already know.
Oh, yeah, I know. Ooh, sweet. Okay. And over here is a second-gen Camaro from the 70s, Z28. I'm guessing that's got to be a 78 or 79. That looks beautiful. And here is a third-gen Camaro from the 80s to the early 90s. And a fourth-gen next to it. SS from the late 90s to early 2000s with the first LS, the LS1. First gen Camaro. It's got to be a 69 or something. It's got the 350 in there. Another first gen next to it as well. I like how they both have their hoods open so you can see their engines and inner workings and all that. It's really neat. It's probably a private booth over here. And there's another sixth gen right over there. Marrow Maniacs. So that's probably the club that owns this, I think. That's probably what those two dudes are from as well. I've got a feeling, yeah. And over here, it's got the Shelby GT500. Doors are open so you can see the inside of it. Supercharged as well. Gotta love that beautiful V8 in there.
Do you have a YouTube channel?
Yes, I do. Yep.
Subscribe right now.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Want to be on this YouTube video?
Absolutely, yep.
Yo, let's go.
Yeah, let's go, okay.
Once we say on YouTube,
yeah.
We're gonna go subscribe right now.
Yeah, so it's Mr. Chevrolet 94. And this will be on YouTube very soon. And here's a Fox Body Mustang. It's a Celine Mustang. That's pretty neat looking. I've seen a lot of Fox Bodies, but not the Celine version. It's pretty neat. Ooh, check this out. Here's an SN95 Mustang right over here. I'm guessing it's a Cobra or something, or a Shelby. Not sure, but it's a good-looking one. It's got paint that changes color as you move in different sides and directions. It's kind of neat. And here's an F100 custom truck with a beautiful V8 in there. And there's a little cartoon caricature art of it too. Wow, what a monster. You gotta love these.
It's got a 390 big block in it.
390 big block. You gotta love the big block. Yep. Respect the big block. That'll give you all that torque and sound. It'll put small blocks in the dust. That's for sure. Yeah. Another Fox body in the middle there. Start them young. Yep, a lot of young kids love this just as much as we adults do. And check this out. Here's a Mustang convertible from the 60s with a beautiful Georgia plate on there.
Yeah, you're right. Go Dogs.
Yeah, go Dogs. Hell yeah, brother.
There
you go. Yeah. This is the Georgia Regional Mustang Club. And there's a second gen Mustang right there. That could also be a Boss 302 or 429, as well as a Mach 1, depending on your trim level. Here's a second gen Mustang convertible. Wow, pretty neat looking interior. And right behind it is a Ford Thunderbird from the 50s. It's got to be a 55 to a 57 model year. And I wonder what those things are on the front bumper. Are those like little air intakes or air horns or police sirens? I have no idea what those are, but that's pretty neat looking. It gives it character. It used to compete with the first generation Corvette back when it came out in 1953. But I assume this has got to be a 55 through a 57 Thunderbird. It's got to be one of them. And next to it is a customized Bronco from the 60s. That's a good-looking Bronco. So much better than the new Bronco, that's for sure. So it's got a bumper with a winch on it, and LED lights, lifted suspension, and off-road tires. You got to love that. Pretty good turnout here at this auto show. But then again, not as many vehicles here as in the boat show. But I feel like there's a pretty good lineup of vehicles here. Well, except the disgusting electric vehicles. Yeah, those I stay away from. Those you should stay away from. Those are terrible. But you should always respect the classics and the sports cars and the big trucks and the custom-built stuff as well. Last but not least, check out the Chevelle 1970 convertible SS. That is beautiful. But if I had one of these, I'd want it to be the hardtop coupe in a brighter red, maybe a torch red or something like that. Kind of like my Corvette a little bit. That'd be sweet. But yeah, it's a 1970 Chevelle. You gotta love it with the big block. It's got the 4-speed in there. What a monster. And it's a big boat too. And it's fun. These are very desirable. You gotta love these monsters. So yeah, that's the 2023 Atlanta International Auto Show. Hope you all enjoyed. And as you all saw, I got a new subscriber. So that's always good to know. And now I'm gonna rendezvous with my mom and dad and head out. And hopefully be back for another showing of this show. Hopefully by next year. Or in the years to come. Because there's always something new and interesting going on at the Atlanta International Auto Show. And ooh, one thing I forgot to point out, they have a little petting zoo here with little cute little puppies. How about that? Wow. Subaru loves pets. That's adorable. That's cute. Yeah, I just thought I'd check that out. So yeah, this auto show is a good turnout. And I'll be back for more showings of this show in many more years to come. Hope you all enjoy the 2023 Atlanta International Auto Show.